Once upon a time, in a great castle, a prince's daughter grew up happy and content, in spite of a jealous stepmother. She was very pretty, with blue eyes and long black hair. Her skin was delicate and fair, and so she was called Snow White. Though her stepmother was a wicked woman, she too was very beautiful, and the magic mirror told her this every day, whenever she asked it. The reply was always, until the dreadful day when she heard it say, the stepmother was furious and white with jealousy and began plotting to get rid of Snow White. Calling one of her trusted servants, she bribed her with a rich reward to take Snow White into the forest far away from the castle and put her to death. The greedy servant agreed to do this deed and he led Snow White away. However, when they came to the fatal spot, the man's courage failed him and leaving Snow White sitting alone, he mumbled an excuse and ran off. Snow White was all alone in the forest. Night came, but the servant did not return. Snow White, alone in the dark forest, began to cry bitterly. She thought she could feel terrible eyes spying on her, and she heard strange sounds. At last, overcome by tiredness, she fell asleep. At last, dawn woke. The forest to the song of the birds, and Snow White too awoke. A whole world was stirring to life. The thick trees were like a wall around her, and as she tried to find out where she was, she came across a path. She walked along it, hopefully. On she walked till she came to a clearing. There stood a strange cottage with a tiny door, tiny windows, and a tiny chimney. Everything about the cottage was much tinier than it ought to be. Snow White pushed the door open. I wonder who lives here, she said to herself, peeping around the kitchen. There must be seven of them. The table was laid for seven people. Upstairs was a bedroom with seven neat little beds. Going back to the kitchen, Snow White had an idea. I'll make them something to eat. When they come home, they'll be glad to find a meal ready. Towards dusk, seven tiny men marched homewards singing. But when they opened the door, to their surprise, they found a bowl of hot steaming soup on the table and the whole house spick and span. Upstairs was Snow White, fast asleep on one of the beds. The chief dwarf prodded her gently. Who are you? He asked. Snow White told them her sad story, and tears sprung to the dwarf's eyes. And one of them said, as he noisily blew his nose, stay here with us! Hooray, hooray, they cheered, and danced joyfully around the girl. Snow White gratefully accepted their hospitality, and the next morning the dwarfs stepped off for work. But they warned Snow White, do not open the door to strangers. Meanwhile, the servant had returned to the castle with a harp with a row of deer. He gave it to the cruel stepmother, telling her it belonged to Snow White, so that he could claim his reward. Highly pleased, the stepmother turned again to the magic mirror. And her hopes were dashed, for the mirror replied, the fairest in the land is still Snow White, who lives in the seven dwarfs' cottage down in the forest. The stepmother was beside herself with rage. She must die! She must die! Disguising herself as an old peasant woman, she put the poisoned apple with the others in her basket. Then, taking the quickest way to the forest, she crossed the swamp at the edge of the trees and arrived at the cottage. Snow White was in the kitchen when she heard the sound of the door. Knock, knock. Who's there? She called suspiciously, remembering the dwarf's advice. I'm an old peasant woman selling apples, came the reply. I don't need any apples, thank you, she replied. But they are so beautiful and ever so juicy, said the voice from outside the door. I'm not supposed to open the door to anyone, said Snow White, who was reluctant to disobey her friends. And quite right too, good girl. If you promise not to open up to strangers, then of course you can't buy. You are a good girl indeed, the old woman went on. And as for reward for being good, I'm going to make you a gift of one of my apples. Without further thought, Snow White opened the door just a tiny crack to take the apple. There, now isn't that a nice apple? Snow White bit into the fruit, and as she did, she fell to the ground in a faint. The effect of the terrible poison left her lifeless. Now chuckling evilly, the wicked stepmother hurried off, but as she ran back across the swamp, she tripped and fell into the quicksand. No one heard her cries for help. She disappeared without a trace. Meanwhile, the dwarfs came out of the mine to find that the sky had grown dark and stormy. Loud thunder echoed through the valleys and streaks of lightning ripped the sky. Worried about Snow White, they ran as quickly as they could down the mountain to the cottage. There they found Snow White, lying still and lifeless, the poisoned apple by her side. They wept and wept for a very long time. Then they laid her on a bed of rose petals, carried her into the forest, and put her in a crystal coffin. Each day they laid a flower. Then one evening, they discovered a strange young man admiring Snow White's lovely face through the glass coffin. After listening to the story, the prince, for he was a prince, made a suggestion. If you allow me to take her to my castle, I'll call the famous doctors to waken her from this peculiar sleep. She is so lovely. I would love to kiss her. And he did. And as though by magic, the prince's kiss broke the spell. To everyone's astonishment, Snow White opened her eyes. She had amazingly come back to life. Now in love, the prince asked Snow White to marry him. And the dwarfs reluctantly had to say goodbye to Snow White. From that day on, Snow White lived happily in the great castle. But from time to time, she was drawn back to visit the little cottage down in the forest.